We are here in downtown Vancouver with Dr. Bob Morrell. Dr. Bob Morrell is an expert doctor in aesthetic medicine, having practiced for 20 years. Now, give us a little of the evolution of Botox. I know it started out as kind of a scary thing.
Well, there's two parts to the evolution. The real evolution is it started in 1965, which few people think, well, that's 55 years ago.
Wow.
And it's been used clinically since then in different ways for medicine and for aesthetic medicine. And when it first came out and used extensively in aesthetic medicine was probably 25 years ago. And there's been an evolution of how it progressed since then, how we look at patients, how effective it is, what unique ways we use it, and it's totally an evolution to the point where you can create a very attractive look of relaxed, natural, and healthy face, and not the scary frozen that you used to hear about 20 years ago. I'm not sure what part of the face that was, but it used to be talked about a lot.
Yeah.
And it's
yeah.
not talked about at all anymore.
No.
But still, one of the major concerns people have is just don't make me look funny. Mm-hmm. And so that is a concern. You're putting needles in people's faces, either in Botox or fillers, and the idea is to enhance the characteristics they have, not to change their face or not to, but to just enhance it. So if a young lady like this comes in, her beautiful eyes, the more we can show her eyes, lift her brows, the more beautiful it is to her. Really, you don't have a lot of lines, but really improving a bit of the aesthetics by opening up your mid-face, showing your eyes like that is spectacular. And if you lift up the edge, it opens up the side and you're just, it's an inviting, beautiful look at your beautiful eyes. If she comes in and the issue is just the frown line, then we look. What is it about that frown line that bothers you?
Mm-hmm. And it's a lot about preventative too, as I've learned over the years. And you don't come in once you have wrinkles, it's very much a preventative method to prevent looking angry and sad and scaring people, basically.
Well, there's two parts to the preventiveness. One is that is actually Botox is good for the skin. All of our expressions of frowning, laughing, eating, it crinkles our skin like cardboard, and that damages it, and that's how come we get wrinkles. Mm-hmm. If you don't have, you have those expressions, but not deep lines forming from them, you're not hurting the skin. So preventative that way. So it's not only just preventative in aesthetically how you mature, but your skin is healthier as you go forward.
Interesting.
I hear a lot of people, one of the questions I hear a lot of people asking is that, okay, what's the downtime? I could imagine you probably would have like a lot of people coming in Friday afternoon or something just so they can have the weekend because they think, oh, I'll be bedridden for 3 or 4 days. But that's no longer the case. Not that it ever but they're just misconceptions.
So there are three parts to downtime. One part is what do you look like when it's just done? So usually, because you're using a fluid, usually you see little bumps in the areas that where you put the Botox, and that lasts about 5 minutes. And so that's not a big thing. Yet if a person looked in the mirror as you did it, you would think, wow, look at this, I've grown horns. But the reality is that lasts 5 minutes. The second part of that is if you did cause a small bruise, that's the downtime people worry about. And so typically you watch and look very carefully to the end of your treatment to make sure that doesn't happen. So it's very rare when a bruise becomes a downtime issue nowadays with the techniques out there.
So Dr. Bob, is there any side effects after all this evolution of Botox?
Well, I gotta tell you about Botox. It's probably the most studied drug in the world. And there's over 3,500 scientific papers written on how it works, what are the complications, how does it, and so it's the most studied drug in the world. Why is it studied so much? Because last year Botox made $44 billion and there's a lot of money behind the research that goes into making sure this doesn't hurt people. And of all of the people that get done with that kind of money, there has never been one lawsuit which is successful in the sense of knowing Botox hurt the person.
Excellent.
Interesting.
Well, good advice. We're going to talk more down the road about some of the other benefits of Botox, including how it can help acne, which is an important thing. Andrea, thank you for being, I won't say volunteer. I guess we threw you in here. Thank you for sitting here with us.
You were really useful.
But
that
we
really
helped. We are going to, though, more in the show, is talk about how you take care of your skin after the fact. It's great to be smooth, but we know that we do need to take care of our skin during the winter months. So we're going to talk to Paris about how to keep that skin supple and beautiful all through the winter.
That's right. That's coming up later in the show.